Keeping the That door is always bothering me. Oh, hi. Hi, what a nice sunny day here in Sesame Street. Sure makes you glad you're a bird. Oh, let's see. Wonder what... Oh, look at this. Mr. McIntosh is here today. He's the man that sells all the fruit and apples and things. Boy, he sure has a nice wagon. Gosh, look at the big wheels it has. Boy, it would sure be fun to have a ride on that. Mr. McIntosh is kind of nice. I bet he really wouldn't mind if I had a ride on it. That would be easy. All I'd have to do is just move over some of this fruit, and then I could get on it and climb up on the top, and then when somebody comes along, I'd get the kids maybe. They could push me. That would really be fun. Well, let's see. I'll just move these apples here. And Oh, no. Oh, boy. Apples everywhere. Oh, I spilled these apples. Boy, is Mr. McIntosh going to be upset when he sees how I spill his apple cart? Oh, no. I better start picking them all up. There's so many, I'll never get him picked up before he comes back. And he's going to be so angry. He'll be so furious. There's only one thing to do. Oh, no. I'm going to have to sneak away from Sesame Street. I'll have to sneak away and never come back. Well, goodbye, Sesame Street. Sneak, sneak, oh, dear.
So Big Bird won't get in trouble.
Okay. Oh boy. Have I got myself in trouble? I've spilled Mr. McIntosh's apples all over the street. Now I've got to run away, because he's really going to be angry when he sees that, and he's probably seen it already by now. So, goodbye, Sesame Street. Nobody will see me in this. They'll never know it's me anyway.
What in the world? It looks like Big Bird's feet and his beak. Big Bird?
I'm not under this sheet.
You're not?
But I'm just sneaking away.
You're sneaking away?
Yes.
Why?
Well, I've done a terrible thing.
You did? What did you do?
Well, I was going to ride on Mr. McIntosh's apple cart. See, he wasn't there, and then I tried to move his apples. And you know what I did?
What?
I spilled them all over the street! And when he sees that, he's going to be so angry and so mad, and I'm going to have to sneak away forever.
Oh, Big Bird, you don't have to sneak away. No, 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 Big Bird, that was only an accident, huh?
Yeah, but he's going to be angry.
All we have to do is pick up the apples, Big Bird, and say that we're sorry to Mr. McIntosh, huh?
Wouldn't it be easier for me to run away forever?
No, that was only an accident. When you do something bad, like an accident, and it's like an accident, you don't have to run away. Come on. Come on.
You mean I won't need this sheet?
No. Yeah.
Well, you're sure he won't be angry, Mr. Looper?
No. Hooper?
Hooper?
Come on.
Are you sure? You sure he's not going to be angry?
Yes. Come on, come on.
Think it's okay?
Yeah, surely, Big Bird. There. There's Mr. McIntosh.
There's Mr. McIntosh.
Come on, speak to him. But you know I told you. All right?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, thanks, Mr. Looper. Hi, Mr. McIntosh.
Hello, Big Bird.
Well, you know, I just wanted to say that I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
For spilling your apples, because...
What are you talking about, Big Bird? My apples are all right.
They are? But, gee, I know I spilled them.
Hola, Gordon, ¿qué pasa?
Oh, hi, Maria. Nothing much. I just broke my mirror.
Well, that's too bad.
Well, I just have to go down the store and buy another one.
I'll walk you.
Okay, come on.
Hey, will you knock off all the... Gee, I thought I heard talking up here. Huh? Look at that. There's somebody here. And he looks like another Grouch. And he looks a lot like me. Do you see that? He's moved in next door. He's got eyes just like mine. And a big mouth just like mine. And look at that green fur. Why, he looks just like me. And he probably likes the same things, too. Like trash. He'll probably want all the trash that I like to find along Sesame Street. I don't think I'm gonna like this. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to get rid of him. Hey, you, listen! This town isn't big enough for both of us, so scram! Huh? Aren't you leaving? Look, get out of here! We don't need you around here. He's not moving. Well, Oscar has a plan. Let's try this. I'm gonna scare him away. Look at this beard. That'll scare him. Booga, 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 booga! You didn't scare. Booga, booga, booga! I'll get something really scary. Watch this. Boo! Boo! Thought the old paper bag trick would work. Let me try the beard again. Booga, 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 booga! Boo! I'm gonna scare him somehow. I'll try one more time. Boo!
I see you're having fun with my old mirror, huh? Well, I'm glad you could find some use for it.
Mirror? Oh my gosh, that is just a mirror. I didn't notice. This is one embarrassed Grouch.
Well, see, my laundry's all washed. Now all I have to do is hang it up. I got these two posts here. So, and I got an old rope. I can easily make a clothesline rope and hang it right on those hooks. But now, I have to figure out how much rope I'm going to need to go from here over to here.
Hi, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Maria.
What you doing?
Oh, I'm just trying to figure out how much rope to cut so I can tie it from this post over to this post so I can hang up my laundry.
Well, you know, I just picked up my tools from the fix-it shop, and I have something you could use right here.
Oh, good.
You can use my ruler.
A ruler?
Yeah. Here, I'll open it up for you.
You mean you'll let me use it?
Sure.
Boy, that's really nice.
It's just been oiled, too. Here.
Oh.
Pick it up later, all right?
Sure, thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Boy, this is nifty. That was really nice. Let's see. Ruler go from here all the way over to there. Hey, that's really great. Well, let me try it out, see how it works. Just hang the clothes up on it. Uh-oh. It's not strong enough. Wonder why Maria thought that would work. Oh, well.
Hello, Big Bird. How are you?
Oh, hi, Mr. Pooper.
Pooper.
I'm just trying to hang up my clothes.
Yes.
And I dropped my everything, you know, like the ruler here.
Yeah.
See, with the ruler, I'm trying to figure out how much rope went by. Maria gave me this ruler for some reason, but it doesn't work.
The ruler doesn't work?
No.
Well, let me see. Huh? Yeah, we'll try it this way, see if it works. There we are. Oh, here we are. That's 5 feet between the two poles. Huh? And with a little more extra to tie it to the poles, we'll be able to work it out. Okay? Here we go. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a little extra comes to here. Now we'll cut it, and I happen to have my scissor with me, and we cut it. There we are. Now we'll tie it to the pole, right? And you'll have a line for your clothes. Here's one end tied to the pole. You got nice fresh rope. Here's another end tied to the pole. Huh? Here we are. And we got it all tied. Huh? There you go. Big Bird. Big Bird! There's the rope tied to the two poles. All measured out.
That's nice, Mr. Looper.
Hooper.
Thanks for helping.
You're welcome.
Boy, laundry takes a long time. Well, I guess I could hang these things up.
Are you done? I guess you are. Did it work? What was it?
Well, I want to thank you, Maria, but it works okay for measuring, but I have to tell you something.
Why?
Don't ever try to hang laundry on it.
Why?
Won't work.
Hey, we're going to play a little game, all right? Okay. Let's see. Here are some things that belong together. They're kind of the same. It's perfectly clear. One of these things here goes with the others. Which one goes in the space right there?
That.
Well, let's see. Which one do you think? Well, we have a piano here, and a saxophone, and a guitar. Over here, we have a harmonica, and we have a banana. Now, which one goes
harmonica.
Here? The harmonica. That's right, man. How'd you know that, Trey? How come that one doesn't go?
Because they both, all those make music.
Right on. That's correct. Right?
Right.
I wonder what I'm going to do with this banana here. Let's see. You take the saxophone, you play that, and you play this harmonica, and I'm going to do this with this banana, I think, because I'm hungry.
Algunas de estas cosas deben ir juntas. Son parecidas, ya lo puedes ver. Una de estas cosas va con las otras. Dime cuál es la que va aquí. Ahora, aquí tenemos un par de pantalones y un guante y un sombrero. Y en este lado tenemos un zapato y un sartén. ¿Verdad que sí? Pero vamos a ver cuál de estas dos cosas tiene que ir en este lado. ¿Cuál crees?
Zapato.
¿El zapato? ¿Estás segura? ¿Y tú? ¿Tú no sabes? No. ¿Y por qué el zapato va aquí? ¿Por qué tú crees?
Porque eso usa cuando alguien se va afuera y el zapato también.
Sí, porque estas cosas se usan para uno vestirse. Son prendas de vestir, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Uno se pone el guante y el zapato y los pantalones y el sombrerito. Pero esto, ¿para qué se usa esto?
Para cocinar.
Para cocinar, así que... Así que el zapato tiene que ir con estas cosas. Fíjate.
That would seem strange. Oh, hi! Hey, you know what I was doing? I was just thinking how funny it would seem if everybody on Sesame Street all looked alike. You know, everybody had the same face and nobody looked any different. You could just imagine what that would seem like. Ah, hi, Susan.
I'm not Susan. I'm Gordon.
Susan, what are you doing in Oscar's trash can?
I'm not Susan. I'm Oscar. Scram, bird.
Mr. Looper. Hello, Mr. Booper. Oh, hi, Susan. I was just looking for Mr. Looper.
I am Mr. Hooper.
Oh, boy, this is really confusing. Boy, I'm really glad that everybody looks different. Because it's really confusing if everybody looked alike. Huh? Susan, is that you?
Yeah, of course it's me.
Oh, wow. For a minute there, I thought you were Mr. Hooper. Mr. Hooper, you here?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters I and P, and by the number 12. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.